Anybody else like a chair before we begin?
In the stillness of this place, we turn to God, who is our beginning and our end. From dust we have been made, and to dust we will return. With reverence, we gather to thank God for the gift of Elsie Poulter to us, and to commit her earthly body to the ground with the confidence that neither life nor death can separate any of us from the love we know in Christ Jesus. Hear now these words of scripture from the Gospel of John. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live, you also will live. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. A reading from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his namesake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May God bless the hearing and understanding of these sacred words. Elsie May Poulter was born August 30th, 1933, near Colusa, Illinois, to Alfred Kenton and Osa Mabel Lohman. Elsie attended school in Dallas City, and on June 8, 1951, she married Richard. She raised her two boys with much love and joy. Ken and Randy cannot recall a meal that she made that they did not love. Ken had a fondness for her Christmas balls that she made every December, and for her cherry pie. Elsie would take full advantage of the food that Dick grew in their garden. Growing up, Elsie would joyfully give the boys what they asked for, as long as it was within their means. She fiercely loved her family, caring not just for her husband and sons, daughter-in-laws, nieces, nephews, siblings, and grandchildren, but for all who were honored to know her and to be loved by her. Always a hostess, wanting to make sure that you felt at home in her house. Elsie cared deeply for others, embodying a central teaching of Jesus. In Jesus' final night with his disciples, according to the gospel writer John, Jesus washed each of his disciples' feet and taught them that in order to follow in his way, they need to serve one another. Adventurous, Elsie traveled with her family to Alaska, Canada, Las Vegas, and thoroughly enjoyed the fall leaf tour they took in New England. A highlight for her sons and their children was the trip that they took to Disney with her. Elsie and Dick loved square dancing, and she loved painting ceramics with her daughter-in-law, Cindy, and her niece, Betty Jo. Memories of Elsie always included her being with another or doing something for another. She was a dedicated member of First Christian Church, as well as a member of King's Daughters. You all possess a lifetime worth of memories about Elsie. Continue to share your stories with one another, with grace and patience. Support one another in this time of loss. Remember together that Elsie was a wonderful wife, mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, daughter, sibling, aunt, and friend. For all who were honored to be loved and to have loved Elsie, we give God our deepest thanks. Amen. I would like to now share a poem that her sons wanted to be read in this moment. When tomorrow starts without me. When tomorrow starts without me, please try to understand that an angel came and called my name and took me by the hand. The angel said my place was ready in heaven far above, and that I'd have to leave behind all those I dearly love. But when I walked through heaven's gates, I felt so much at home. For God looked down, smiled at me, and told me, "Welcome home." So when tomorrow starts without me, don't think we're far apart. For every time you think of me, I'm right there in your heart.
How great thou art.
having commended Elsie, our companion on life's journey, into the hands of God, we now commit her body to the ground, confident that the one who has made us shall not leave us in the dust, but in Christ give us the victory of eternal life. We look toward that final day when, as scriptures promise, God will wipe every tear from their eyes. There shall be an end to death and to mourning, crying and pain, for the old order has passed away. Will you pray with me? God of heaven and earth, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. God of all life, we thank you for the gift of Elsie that we remember here today. We ask that you be with us in the days ahead as sorrow and loneliness weave their shadow around us. Through the power of Christ's resurrection, restore our hope and give us strength to carry on with our lives. We pray that your grace and love will be an abiding presence in this time of need. Fill our spirits with the truth of life. Grant us your peace. Amen. Receive now this blessing. Watch over us this day and all days. Give us the strength to accept what is past, to appreciate what is present, and to look forward to the good in our future. Holy One, grant us peace, sacred moments of communion with each other, and faith in whatever most expresses our deepest inner truth. Bless us and heal us, breathe peace and grace into our lives. Amen. This completes our service. On behalf of Randy and Ken, I thank you for coming, and they would like to extend an invitation to all of you to join them at the Pink for lunch today.
There's a register book on the back corner of the tent here if you haven't had a chance to sign that. If you do that before you leave, please.